Hello. In this video, we'll take a look at how you can import your existing survey designs into mWater or Solstice using spreadsheets. There are now two different ways to do this in either platform. You can use our simple template to bring in straightforward survey designs in a quick and simple way. And for more complex surveys, you can use the XLSForm option. This is particularly relevant if you have a set of surveys designed in another system, like ODK, which uses the same format to export them, and then you can import them, those survey designs, into mWater or Solstice easily. I do want to add that if you're just creating a new survey in the platform, then the best option is to use the online survey designer. That's what it's there for, and it has the best set of tools and options for you to build exactly the kind of survey design that you want. To go a little bit deeper into the two options, the simple template has a very, very simple format in a spreadsheet with just three column options: the question type, the question name, and question choices where relevant, and these will be comma delimited. And then in the spreadsheet, you fill in those columns, and every row that you fill in will become a question in the survey. Once you've imported this simple template, you will then have a survey in the survey designer that you can keep editing and adjusting and making more complex. And the XLSForm option is for more complex surveys with things like conditionality and more complex question types, sections, and so on. And as mentioned, it's particularly good because it's a standard format and other systems can export survey designs into that format. We'll start with a simple template in this video, and I'll just cover the question types that the template accepts, which is a smaller amount than the platform has. So in the template, you've got these six question options. When you're designing surveys in mWater or Solstice, you have many more question options. So you can, the simple template handles text questions, number questions, single choice questions, and multi-choice questions, as well as location questions, which draw on the device GPS, and finally, site questions, which are the perfect option when you want to do longitudinal infrastructure monitoring of things like schools, health facilities, communities, and so on. Okay, let's get started. How do we actually go through this process? Well, I'm here on the solstice.world homepage, and the same applies for the mWater portal. I'll go to the surveys page where I can either choose to create a new survey and be brought to the online designer, but in my case, I want to import an existing design. So I'll click Survey Design Import. Here we see the two options, XLSForm and Simple Design. Let's begin with the Simple Design for clarity. And here I can download the template, choose the base language. And if we look at the template, I've got a pre-filled option here. So we get these three column options, as I mentioned, and I've filled a few in. So we've got a question called the linked water point, which will be a site question. Got a geography type question, which is a radio or a single choice question. And the choices I'm giving this question are these. So I've got urban, comma, rural, comma, peri-urban. Three choices, each separated by a comma. We've got a number question called water level in our example, and then a multi-choice question, so where a user can choose one or more options, called problems present, and I've just given a simple set of options here, mechanical, comma, electrical, comma, water quality. So I fill in my template, I save it down, and then I go to the next step in the importer, and I add the import file here. I've dragged and dropped it here, and now I can do some mapping if needed. So remembering that the geography type was a radio question, there we go, number question, and multi-check question like that. Finally, I've got the site question, and I will map it to a particular site type out of the available options. And this, of course, will be the water point, or a linked water point. And I've mapped all the rows, pretty happy, and I'll click import. And there we go. we're brought to the survey designer with our new untitled survey. And what do we see? We see the site question here called linked water point. We see this single choice radio button question, which we can edit, we can change around as makes sense. We can display it differently as toggles, whatever. It's just part of the regular designer. The number question for the water level and our multi-choice question. We could have added as many more questions as we want, and then we can start moving these around, editing the survey, and so on. So this is the easy option, the survey simple template import. Next, let's take a look at the XLSForm import flow. And here I'm doing the same thing of going to the surveys page and then selecting the survey design import to get started. And then choosing XLSForm. Now, the XLSForm is this general standard that's available, that exists outside of mWater, exists outside of Solstice, and it's a form standard created to help simplify the authoring of forms or surveys in Excel. And there's comprehensive documentation available at this website, xlsform.org, where I'd advise you to go and take a look if you're getting familiar with this format. And what we've done is make mWater and Solstice able to take these files, parse them, process them, and turn them into draft surveys. There's a lot of information about the details, and the key point is that it's a much more advanced and complicated format than the simple template. If we take an example file here, we see some key columns like question type, name, label, the name is more like an ID, and many more fields like the hint and other things. I won't cover the format in detail, I'll more focus on the workflow, assuming that you have a good XLSForm handy. I do want to mention that this spreadsheet has multiple tabs. In the simple template, we see that all the choices are delimited by comma in the main tab, but instead, in the XLSForm, everything is mapped to a second tab. So this is, in a certain way, clearer, but it adds more complexity to the design of the XLSForm. There are further parameters that can be set in the Settings tab, some of which may translate into fields in mWater. So this is an example of the XLSForm. Let's just assume that we have a good XLSForm file. Maybe you've exported one from ODK or something. I'm dragging it here into the importer, and we can see the import process happening. Great. Now, this is a very long survey with even hundreds of questions. So there may be errors or questions that come up during this import process, or some things that just don't fit within the mWater or Solstice way of designing surveys. So you will get a notification for each time this happens. So here on row one, that's the case. And then here, 100 rows later, there are some kinds of question types, perhaps, that are not supported. But that's fine. You'll be able to view this list of issues from the top right here. But everything else has been successfully imported. So you'll see a very complex design was imported with just basically dragging and dropping a file. We have multi-choice and single choice and text fields. But unlike the simple template, there are many more question type options that this can handle. So we see photo questions, and unit questions, and many other things in our example survey. So then we've imported this draft version. There's one extra step we want to take with the XLSForm importer. Because these formats tend to be quite complex, you may want to move things around or address some of these errors that we saw before you save this file. So this is not yet a properly saved survey design in Solstice or mWater. You have to yourself click the save button before it saves it down, or address some of these errors in the file and then start over. I'll choose to save the file, and then we get taken to the standard Solstice survey designer. There is now a unique ID for this survey. It has been saved and this design is in our database and accessible by you. And again, here you can continue to edit this survey get it into the shape you want, adjust the conditionality, whatever you need. But you didn't need to, you know, add these hundreds of questions manually again by yourself when you already had them in a spreadsheet. So that is the XLS form import in a nutshell. So we've looked at both of these flows in this video. Those are the basics. Hopefully you've got a good sense of the use cases, when to use one, when to use another, simple template for straightforward surveys that you're designing. Maybe you want to design it collaboratively offline or outside of mWater and Solstice, and the XLS form for more advanced surveys, and especially when you're switching platforms, coming over to mWater and Solstice, maybe from a place that can export survey designs into XLS form. Another step you'll probably want to take in that case is to bring existing survey data on. We have different guides for that, but that happens from the responses tab. So importing a survey design is one thing, and importing actual rows of data is another thing you can also do in our platform. So there we go. That was what I wanted to cover in this video. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on other channels to keep up to date of our latest guides and new features. We're constantly developing the platform and also love to hear from you so that we can keep the platform as up to date and relevant and useful and bug-free for you as possible. So thanks for watching and hope to see you later. Bye.